Hi, and welcome to the Easy Way channel.
Call of Duty Warzone 2.0 has finally got an update, which should fix all this crazy errors, crashes, game not launching at all, and I don't know what kind of issues this game didn't have since it was launched. If you still experience any of these issues I just said, I will leave you links to my videos explaining how to fix them. In today's video, we will go through all settings you need to adjust to get best performance out of your Call of Duty Warzone 2. After applying these settings, your game will run much smoother. You will lose all that micro stuttering that you might have all the time randomly happening while playing, and greatly increase your FPS. So without further ado, let's jump into settings. First thing you will do is to close Warzone 2, and also exit from Steam or Battle.net launcher, depending over which launcher you play. This is a must, because this first setting can't be applied if all that is running. Open Windows Explorer, then Documents, Call of Duty, and then Player Folder. File you are looking is this options.3.cod22cst file. Just right-click on the file, select Open With, and select Notepad or WordPad. Scroll all the way down until you see this option, Render a Worker Count. Here, you need to insert the number of total cores your CPU have. If you don't know how much cores you have, right-click on Taskbar and select Task Manager. Select Performance tab, select CPU, and down here you see next to cores, I have number 6, so that means I have 6 cores. Take that number, go back to this file, and on this spot, enter that number, if there is any different number. With this, you will increase your FPS in Warzone 2.
To apply this, click here on File, and then Save.
Now, I want you to go and restart your computer, then come back here, and check that it reverted to number that was before you applied your core number. If it is, change it again, save, and then right-click on this file, and select Properties. Check this box, next to Read Only. Click on Apply, and then OK. This will prevent that you lose this setting every time you restart your computer. Next, we will go into NVIDIA Control Panel, and make some adjustments there. Right-click on Desktop, and select NVIDIA Control Panel. Here you will check this setting. Use the Advanced 3D Image Settings. Now click on Manage 3D Settings. You can go on Program, and add Call of Duty EXE file, and apply these settings to only that game. But I would recommend you to make these settings here, in Global Settings. I will not going over each setting here, and explain what to select. You will pause the video, and copy all these settings, just like you see them here. When you are done, click down here on Apply. Click on Configure Surround, PhysX, and under Processor, select your GPU. Not Auto Select, not CPU, but your actual GPU. Click on Apply, and then select Change Resolution. Check Use NVIDIA Color Settings. Select Highest, 32-bit. Leave this at 8BPC. If you have Output Color Format down here, select RGB, and Output Dynamic Range to Full. Click on Apply to save this settings. Click on Adjust Desktop Color Settings, and copy all these settings. These last two settings, Change Resolution, and Desktop Color Settings, don't have anything with game performance, lagging and increasing your game FPS. Those two are only visual settings adjustments, and your game, with these settings will look much, much better. Don't forget to apply all these settings, and you can now close NVIDIA Control Panel. Next, click on Start, and select Settings. Click on Gaming, and on the left side, select Game Mode. Toggle this switch to On, because this will help your game to get few more FPS, and your Warzone 2 will run a bit better. If you already tried this on Warzone, and it did nothing, Just turn it on for Warzone 2.0, and you should see the difference.
Click here on the right side on the graphic settings.
This setting, on the other hand, was recommended in Warzone. But now, in Warzone 2.0, it is actually bad. If you have this hardware accelerated GPU scheduling option turned on, you will turn it off. It is proven that leaving this option on cause micro stuttering in Warzone 2.0 and have bad effect in overall performance of the game. So just turn this option off. Also, if you added Warzone 2.0 down here, click on it and select remove. After turning on or off hardware accelerated GPU scheduling, you have to restart your computer, otherwise this setting will not be applied. You can now close this window. Last settings we will do is our in-game settings. So open your game, go to settings, select graphics, and then quality.
Under upscaling, sharpening, you will select NVIDIA image scaling. Then click on show more. And under preset, select balanced, and here, adjust to 75.
Now I will slide through these settings very slow, so you can pause video and copy all these settings to your game. When you are done, don't forget to press apply. After you have done with all these settings, go up here to display tab, and scroll all the way down to this option, restart shaders optimization.
You will click on that and select restart.
After that, your all settings will be applied. You will turn off the Warzone, exit completely from game, and Steam or Battle.net launcher, and restart your computer. After that, launch Warzone, and you will see the difference. In game performance, in FPS, no more stuttering, the whole game will perform much better if you applied all these settings that I showed you, from modifying that CST file, game and graphics settings in Windows, to NVIDIA control panel, and finally in game settings. I will also remind you that you keep your graphic card driver up to date, and also regularly check for Windows updates. Install every update you have, because that is the best way to keep your gaming experience at maximum level. And with this, we came to the end of this video. I hope this video helped you. And if it did, please hit that like button, hit thanks button if you can, and subscribe with the bell on for more videos like this. See you in next one. Bye.